thank you, Mike. Dude, Mars, thank you for the sub. Oremos, thank you so much for that prime. Dark Bros, thank you guys for the sub. Thank you for the 25th giga. Oh, guys, Ray's behind me. I'm in pegging range. I better be careful. Hello, Ray. Sing along. Okay, I'll sing along. No way to I nailed that solo.
I'm running on empty. I'm chasing the dead dream. I'm all out of time. I'm all out of time. No way to heal. Running on empty. Chasing a dead dream. I'm all out of time.
Okay.
Oh my god.
There, did you guys like my singing?
Help me suck this guy off.
It's a good song. Let's see what song's next on the playlist. I'm just gonna hit next. Yeah! Thank you, Catastrophist, for the tier 3. You're a Catastrophist. You've been gone too long at the midnight sea. Oh, what's becoming of me? Les Yona, thank you for the primer. Thank you, Renok, Freemans, Motorola's, Chef Omri. Simple Sloth, Zash, Maddie Cupcake. Alright, let me put my VR chat screen on. Oh wow, that loaded instantly. Hey, what's up? What's up, ballers? It's coming for you. Edible Panties, thank you for the sub. Marcy, thank you for the sub. Light. What was the intro song? No Way to Heal by Trivium. Gotta get away! Get away! Ignored your sub? I wasn't up to that point yet. Oh, I did actually ignore it. Jimmy Brackets, thank you for the sub. Jimmy. Raffle, can you give this sub to Mori, please? I'll think about it. Valenthesis. Thank you so much for the sub. 40 yield. Celeste, Locomotive, 99. Penny Drive. Nevadas. This song fucks. This is Killswitch Engage's cover of Holy Diver. Let's see if I can nail this solo, dude. I'm gonna try. I don't remember this song that much. Thank you, Terry, for the sub. I don't remember how it goes. Nope, I'm not nailing the solo. Nope, I definitely don't remember how the solo goes. Nope, I got that part. Thank you, Syrupy VR, for the sub. I'm a bit washed on this remake. I can mouth any Trivium solo, but this solo I don't remember. Rough day for me, but I'm gonna just relax and enjoy the stream. Listen, there's one thing I always do when I'm really stressed, okay? And that is just jerk off a lot. I remember when you named Trivium songs with like 1 second of playback. I did do that. Okay. Chat, how are you guys today? Bad. I'm great. So most of you guys are just severely depressed.
I got COVID. I'm gonna give it to you.
You're just severely depressed, huh, guys? It's okay. Listen, the week just started. Probably plenty of stuff to do this week, you know? Plenty of content. Your life is fucking awesome. That's great.
I don't know. I have some sort of
Sunday means you have to go back to college tomorrow. Ooh. I got pizza and Kool-Aid. Damn. I found that back to school has never affected this stream too hard, which is good. Oh shit, new sub with the Prime. Ignorance. Aliens won't abduct you. They have to study you first. There's no point. Oh, sorry to hear that, Michael. Been there, dude. That shit's rough. Dude, my throat is fucked. On an unrelated note, last night was really fun. I had a really fun night last night. It was fucking crazy. I think we had more dancers at DJ night last night than we had like non-dancers. It was actually absurd.
What did I say?
It was just like a dance apocalypse. There was just people dancing everywhere. It wasn't even just all lap dancers. It was like fucking all sorts of crazy shit happening. And it was dancing until the early morning. Last night was pretty wild, actually. Probably the best DJ night I've ever had, honestly.
Everybody wants to fuck War Machine. This is a common factor.
Sounds like it was popping. How am I doing today? Is my stomach feeling better? My stomach is feeling a bit better. I legit think I had food poisoning because my stomach felt like shit until like 2 days ago. Actually, until like yesterday.
He was dying of an injury and I was coddling.
It's a bit worrying. Nah, it just happens, you know. When you eat like shit, some days your stomach just feels like it's gonna implode and kill you. Jeremy, thanks for gifting a sub. Epic, dude. Thank you guys. We're at 4,900 after a weekend. That's not too bad. It means we don't have to bait too much to get back up to 5K.
Hello.
Hi, Crumpet.
What's going on back here?
We're just jerking off together.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
I'd do it too, but my hands are too big for my penis, so.
At that point, do you just go like a couple fingers?
You want me to lobster claw pinch my dick? Bro, I'm into degradation, but I'm not doing that much. Jesus.
See, the only thing... I think the only reason I would care if I had a small penis was because if you have a small donger, then you can't get salt and pepper shakered. And salt and pepper shaker is like S tier.
All you gotta do is find you a bitch with like malformed tiny ass hands. Like, you ever see the Charger from Left 4 Dead? Its other arm is like super small, so you just gotta find like a bitch with tiny hands.
What the fuck is that? What's a salt and pepper shaker? We need someone who's super horny who can... Okay, Vray immediately knew. That's a salt and pepper shaker.
That's a technique you use to masturbate a penis with your hands.
Yeah.
You mean the glizzy overdrive?
The glizzy overdrive?
Oh,
no, Jufa's here. Fuck, we just taught Jufa another thing.
I don't know your TikTok terminology. I'll be right back. I don't understand it, and I'm pissed.
Any Quasimodos in the chat? Mr. Rhombus, what is a salt and pepper shaker? Yeah, you know what? That's another thing that Chufa knows now. Oh god, what are we creating, dude? Should I just embrace it eventually?
And then she won't have to learn anymore.
Should I just embrace that they're doomed? Ash could just become the new wholesome
dude. Send. Yeah, you just replace, right? And then it'll be
Why are you looking like that?
Because if they learn that it doesn't bother you, then you'll be free.
For now, perhaps? Yeah, Ash is pretty fucked, I would say.
They're gonna be. Vray hasn't taken her eyes off her. Wherever Ash goes, Vray's short behind, bro. Like, this gawk queen chasing little Snow White. Rat Snow White.
Aw, thanks for the fire.
Last night, chat.
You're such a good boy.
And we're gonna regroup with everyone in a second. I'm just giving people some time to join. Last night, chat, Mori joined DJ Knight. Came up to me, tied an invisible leash around my neck, pulled me all the way into the back room, said, come here, puppy. I said, okay. Made me sit down on the ground, and then showed me their new avatar. And I have to say, it was a really good avatar. Their new avatar is pretty sick. And then they said, do you think we should show this to chat? And I said, yes, we should absolutely show this to chat. So, at some point, you guys will probably see Mori's new avatar, which is really fucking... I'm telling you, it's definitely my type.
You should introduce it the same way, though. So, since you're chat's eyes, you should have Mori loop you around with an invisible leash again, and then, like, effectively be walking chat around and then reveal it in the same manner.
It's a good idea, chat. Chat, you guys are getting good at baiting, dude. You guys are... Dude, you guys finally got my back, chat. Like, I like that, dude, you know? You guys have my back. You know, you guys are like at 5k question mark? I like that.
You guys are homies.
Sounds like a good idea, though. Okay, I think that's enough time for people to join, right? Can you give all your 6 subs to Mori? Oh, yeah. Let's see who won last week. Let's see who baited the most last week. I think it was Jufa. It was Jufa with 111. Second place was Crumpet with 55. So we have to wait. We have to have a date with Jufa, but every single date has ended with.
You're gonna have to fuck Jufa.
I did not change. I just dipped my fingers in the pool. I dipped my toes in the pool.
That's a joke, right?
No, the
NASCAR
isn't over.
Nope. Every date, it only ends one way.
Oh my god. Wait, this is like, this is actually the worst scenario ever. I have to choose whether, which, what I want to break, okay? Me not looting Jufa, or me break the streak of how every date has ever gone.
The problem with breaking a streak is there's no guarantee that it'll come back. So what if you break the streak, and then every day from then on, it starts a new streak where you just don't have sex?
Oh, dude, Bob, the sorry one was literally the worst of them all. And you're right, Crumpet. Fuck.
Well, there's only one thing you can do. You have to have hate change their entire body to be you, and then just have hate do it instead.
That's a good idea, hate. Okay, they ran away.
Solution.
But the thing is, well, I can't have hate be me, because hate can't do what I can do. You know, hate's like a little submissive mute.
Yeah, pussy.
Yeah, I mean, yeah,
well, you gotta find someone to fuck Jufa who can play you.
Fuck. No, not you. I don't want you near my mute. You're a corrupter. You're a corrupter. It would have to be Mori. It can't be anyone else. It would have to be Mori.
You approach Mori, you sit her down and say, listen, I need you to fuck Jufa as me. Cool?
Yeah. It's a good idea.
She probably
you
did.
Dom energy.
They're pretty
so
close.
Tiny. I love how like I had to crouch down to even see that message. I got Dom energy.
I believe it. At the Gawk Geek Sex Bunker 3000, I'm sure there's something there.
Alright, let's get this shit started, yeah? Let's go out there.
Elbow in my nose! Ow!
Ugh. Hi guys, welcome to Sunday. Yo. Hi. Hi guys. Welcome to Sunday callouts, shoutouts, and hangouts. Anyway, I hope you guys had a good weekend. I hope you guys have lots of things to talk about. As always, you can go over there if you have any announcements, call-outs, or anything, okay? Let's start off with the basics, some announcements. I need some music. There we go. Oh, yeah, that's good. All right, some announcements. I think the art showcase is next week, right, guys? And I believe the theme is, like, Easter eggs. So make sure you guys finish your art pieces in the next week, all right? This is pretty... It's pretty good when a lot of people participate. Hello, yes. Jalumpho. Come have a seat.
Yo, how do you suck this guy off?
It's the 27th.
It is?
Where are you? But yeah. Easter was months ago.
It's the 23rd.
Just fucking do it. Just do the damn art showcase, okay? Unless you suck dick at art, and then just don't do it. Because I don't want to see a bunch of Microsoft Paint bullshit, alright? But if you're good at art, come submit an art piece, you know? We'll love to see it. Everyone will think you're super epic. A bunch of people will message you and be like, hey, you know what? I want to commission you. Here's $500. And then you make some big money, dude. And then you're all set. All right? That'll be epic. oh, man. We're kind of low on callouts today, dude. So we're going to have to... I'm going to have to buy some time by telling some stories and stuff. Last night was a lot of fun.
I've been lied. I'm just eating a brownie.
What the fuck did you just say? Was that...
That's what? Great, Crumpy.
So true, Crumpy. So true. So true.
Why do you sound like that?
Can you hear me, hello?
Shit.
What do I sound like?
No, you sound better now. Your mic sounded like static fucking hell, dude. It literally sounded like garbage.
Well, I said I'm in line. I'm just eating a brownie in my bathroom with the microwave on.
The microwave, that's why your mic got fucked.
In your bathroom?
The nuclear waves of the microwave fuck with you know, the signals of the 5G.
But you have a microwave in your bag.
Okay, well, he's not saying
that's
anything,
true.
So I'm just gonna move on to the next thing. Okay.
He wants breakfast in bath.
Man, I just did nothing.
I had a lot of fun last night. For those of you guys who showed up last night, everyone killed it. Last night was a great party. Probably the most fucked up I've gotten in a little while. Woke up with a sore back. Don't know why. So if anyone could tell me why, let me know. Mika Moonlight, come on by. Hi, Mika Moonlight, the most marketable mute in VR chat. Sorry you made me stutter. Okay, here we go. I have a new outfit. I made it myself from scratch. All it will cost is the... Oh, you're trying to get ahead of the game.
Thank
All
you for
it
the
will
sound.
Cost is the low, low price of 20 giftas, and I'll show it off. Okay, so... If you gift in honor of Mika Moonlight, and Mika Moonlight gets up to 20, all right, you will unlock a new outfit, all right, for Mika Moonlight, and a chance to have a one-on-one date with Mika Moonlight. Would you be able to handle a one-on-one date? You know how they've all ended, right? Oh, okay. Well, we'll talk about it later, okay? I won't spoil any surprises, you know? I don't want anything to be spoiled. So yeah, chat, Mika Moonlight is available for bait, okay? Which I have to make a new one. It's all fresh now, guys. If you gift something, tell me who you gift it towards. We could have a one-on-one date at the end of the week, all right? Mika streams Friday, though. It doesn't have to be Friday. It could literally be any day of the week. The real question is, do we do it on Kick or do we do it on Twitch? If it's on Kick, then that means it's a little more lewd. If it's on Twitch, that means it's a little more RP-focused. So that's really up to Mika. I would have to ask Mika what Mika wants, you know? Whether or not we're gonna sit there and just stare at Mika's underboob for 20 minutes, or whether or not, you know, we'll have like a nice RP adventure with Mika. Stream it on Reddit? Who the fuck streams on Reddit besides the fucking Nitro Bird?
Jaboobie! Jaboobie does!
Oh, that's true,
Jaboobie.
Jaboobie!
Woo, Jaboobie!
Jaboobie gang! Okay, thank you, Mika Moonlight.
Jaboobie.
GTs, good talk.
I'm his best friend.
Jaboobie.
Jaboobie died.
Jalumpho.
Oh, he's dead. Oh my god.
Yeah, Wingflo died on the stage. Just, like, literally just randomly died.
One more.
No.
One more left.
We'll clean it up after. We'll clean it up after the show.
Oh shit.
Hello, Jalumpho.
Oh shit.
Do you have a shout out or call out?
It's just fear.
Delirious right now.
Uh oh. Okay, Jufa is angry. Attention to anyone in the possession of the body of Mr. Rhombus. I'm right here.
Yeah, I got you.
Hand it over now, right now. Oh, okay. It's Lisa. Lisa has my body. I could message Lisa. Can you send me the avatar? I require the flesh of Rhombus. What are you planning on doing with it exactly? I will send it to you, no problem. I don't care if you have it, but what are you gonna do with it? A Robert Gator Fa outfit, Mr. Rom. So you're gonna make an outfit based off my outfit? Alright, I'm down for it. I'm okay with it. As long as you don't wear my skin directly. That'd be weird, right? Why'd you open your eyes when I said that? Yeah, that'll be fun. Thank you, Jufa. I'll get it to you. I just messaged Lisa right now. Okay, well, Lisa wants a one-on-one date and is baiting and is saying, I'm holding it hostage. I will exchange it for 5 subs. Dude, the baits are so unreal nowadays. Why are you looking at me like that? There's people that have to make call-outs, and you're sitting here looking at me like I'm crazy. Make it 100... Oh, make it 15? But then who gets the bait? If you brought it up to 15. Thank you, Gerben. It's very important that I know, like, who gets what. 10 minus 5... 10-5 split. So you're trying to one-up them, but you already have it this week. Dude, it's crazy how quiet it is right now, actually, because I'm talking to a mute, and somehow, that miracle to get this many people to be silent. It's actually incredible. I cannot believe it. This is actually, I think, a first. I may not win, but I shall contribute to the Rhombus cause. Thank you, Jufa.
Anyway, so how are you, Catman?
Fuck you.
I'm chilling.
Okay.
Just chilling. Man, I wish Rob heard this shit up. God damn.
What's your line anymore?
Blah, blah, blah,
I also
blah.
Updated your avatar for with a seat for Scared Jalumpho to sit on. Reload avatar. Do you want me to have a seat? Okay. How do I reload? I just swapped to a different one. All right. This one's probably naked. So if you're streaming, look away from me.
Hell yeah.
Oh God.
I'm staring.
Okay. It's not. All right.
Really?
I'm gonna assume it's not.
Whoa!
Oh my god.
You sure?
Whoa.
You're positive.
Yeah, pretty close.
It's like 90% naked.
Listen, we head up to H parties, man. I mean, what
if
do you want, you know?
We'd be safe.
Yeah.
Mr. Rhombus, what's that sausage hanging down? Is that a salami? Yeah, it's a salami.
H party was lit last night.
It was pretty good. It was pretty good. The after party for DJ Night was a public age party, guys, just so you know. And it was pretty wild. What happened? I mean, what can I say? A very wasted Gothic Bunny put on a very good show. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Next. Oh, did you have more you wanted to say?
Yo, yo, yo. What's up, Rob?
What's up?
Come on, COVID. Fucker man,
alright, I got a shout out and I have a call out. So.
Okay.
Shout out to the group of troublemakers that came and terrorized the Maid Cafe today. So, that would be Baslixian, High Nero, Jinx, and TK.
Wow, what did they do to disrupt it?
Y'all know who to ban now.
They were just running around and causing havoc. But no, for real, it was a good time, though. It was a good time.
We killed a couple of people.
We actually killed like a couple of the maids. Butler, we tried to kill the host. We kill. It started with getting loved.
What the fuck is this dude ever talking about?
Yeah, it was pretty cool. It was pretty cool. Lots of bloodshed.
Yeah, one of the maids came up to go again.
Maybe I can do a sacrifice. Yeah.
Yeah, it was
really
fun.
You also tried to rob me.
Yeah, I did. I got roped into it, so I had no choice.
Epic.
But you had a pretty good time, right?
Okay, sorry.
Yeah, no, I had a great time. But it made me remember something, Rob. Weren't you supposed to go at some point?
To where? The maid cafe?
To the maid cafe. Weren't you supposed to go
only?
With Chufa and Mori and have discount as your lovely butler?
I mean, isn't it literally invite only?
Thanks for the five.
Yeah, but I can invite you.
Such a good boy.
Okay, did you invite me?
Yeah, like 5 or 6 times now in the last 2 months.
Okay, well, I'm gonna
I kind of gave up. So
hold on, I'm gonna
because like go here.
Sorry, I accidentally.
I sent you something. You missed out on some quality stuff. Moments like what I just sent.
It's you pinned against the wall from discount. That literally doesn't appeal to me at all. Why do I care?
What do you mean? It's quality moments. You're missing out on
why
epic
did
and then instantly like pinned against the wall.
Dude, this motherfucker put. I'm not even kidding, chat. Hold on. I'm gonna show you the screenshot.
Spoiler.
This motherfucker put a spoiler on this.
It's too dangerous. It's too hot. It's way too hot. Very steamy.
Yeah, one of the customers was asking me how to riz, and I just slammed Bass up against the wall and, you know, did my thing, so.
Yeah,
you
did, like, fully throw me against the wall.
You didn't riz it properly. I'm gonna teach you. Your form is incorrect, okay? When you do the slam, when you slam someone against the wall, you don't bend your elbows like that. Okay, let me show you. Okay, hold on.
Can I shrink real quick? Can I get another demonstration?
When you bend your elbow, the way you're doing it is kind of feminine. Like, you have to, like, fucking go straight. Like, your arm has to go straight forward. It needs to be, like, perpendicular with your shoulder. That's a limp dick fucking wall slam.
I don't have elbow trackers.
Use your leg.
You don't need elbow trackers.
Yeah, you just
they just need
your
to
arm
go
forward.
Straight forward.
Okay.
Yeah. Are you in VR?
Here, let's try it again.
No, unfortunately, no. None of us are. You have 4 desktop users. Okay, go ahead. Try and hit me with it. I even shrunk for you this time.
Nope, you're still bending.
No,
you look like you're trying to kiss him.
You're still
yeah, see, that's
you're,
better now,
you're
right?
You're still bent. Now you, it looks like you're gripping
my head. Yeah, well,
this
isn't desktop, so I was in VR before.
Then get in VR! God! What the fuck am I to you?
I'm not getting a VR.
This is homoerotic.
Like, you look. This doesn't look like domming. This looks like you guys are like in love with each other, like about to kiss each other. Like this literally doesn't look like domming at all.
Excuse me. The only person
he's so scared of me. He's sinking into the wall.
You guys just. I am trying to escape. That is me trying to fade away and rage into the wall to run away.
Okay, well, as a person who hangs out with a lot of mutes, okay?
Huh?
They wouldn't even have an opportunity to look up. There would just be so much fear in their eyes that they would just be done for.
If I was in a public, this is uploaded to my account.
That's fucked up. That's
insane. But, anyway, I'm glad you guys had a nice time at the maid cafe. Was Lorraine there?
Yeah, Lorraine was there too.
That's
it was a good day.
Lorraine squished my face with massive tits.
So are you gonna come at some point? With?
I mean, I'll come, yeah. Just let me know. What time is it at?
Maid cafes are weird.
They're usually like 8 p.m. EST.
I'm gonna be honest.
Way before stream.
If you had asked me a month ago, I would be like, yeah, okay? Because I need someone to freaking, like, I need someone to fulfill my
Bro.
Needs to fucking sit there and make me feel like, you know, like I'm being cleaned up after and all this stuff. But nowadays, I don't know, man. I feel like there's just been so many people that just, like, want to do my bidding that I don't need to go to a maid cafe anymore.
Christ.
Yeah, well, the thing is, Rob, is I did ask you. I asked you like 4 or 5 times a month ago. So.
That's true. But I'll probably still go.
It's just this guy's a fucking.
You should go.
Box.
It's a fun time. You can bring three people with you.
Suffering
so.
From success. Listen, chat. I'm just gonna enjoy it until the next time I fall into depression. Okay. I need to be humbled. Why do I need to be humbled? I'm literally constantly miserable. I'm happy for once in my fucking life, and I need to be humbled. I don't understand. What does that even mean?
No, this guy needs to get taken down a peg. That's what I'm saying.
I would suggest, Rod, bring Jinx with you. She'll try to wingman you. It's pretty fun.
I mean, I love Jinx. I would hang out with Jinx just to hang out with Jinx, but do you think I need a wingman?
Good one, Booger Boys.
Trust me. She'll give some interesting prompts to the mates.
What does that mean?
What is that?
Huh? It was wild, but you should have been there.
But I'm the prompt guy. I'm the guy that gives the prompts.
Booger Boys. Assemble.
I'm the one who knows.
Well, Rob, next time you're feeling depressed and you need to be humbled, Virtual Mate Cafe has your back. So,
but why would I go somewhere to be humbled? Yeah, I want somewhere to be non-humbled.
Bro, there's a bunch of mutes that want to feed you food, man. Just come and hang out. It's fun.
But that literally happened on Kick like 3 days ago.
Oh, this guy. Okay, man. I'll just bring Lazzy instead.
I already have J. Robert Oppenheimer.
I'll go. Are they good? Are they good mutes? Okay, or are they some fucking dog shit like fucking mutes that are like fucking non quirky, like no body movement? Like, okay, do they move?
Okay, I got fine with that.
There's a couple good mutes and there's a couple good talkers too, man. You would like it.
I don't know.
You know, Lorraine's there.
Do they move like Maury or do they move like Maverick?
Chuck Torito's there.
Okay, do you think any of what you... None of that sells it, dude. Oh, dude, I can't wait to hang out with Boulevardy, dude. That's so epic, man. I'm gonna have such a good time with Boulevardy.
Okay, dude. Well, you know, you can hang out with me.
What?
You
see did you see the picture that
Minnie
made?
Yeah. Yeah, you know what? I don't
want to
go to
the
maid cafe.
Oh, shit, I'm gonna pick that.
Yeah.
Think about it. You, Vincent, Lazzy.
He actually photoshopped you. With a bunch
of that sounds like a great time, man.
Yo, that's the crew right there.
Listen, dude. Why don't you get like.
Yeah, and Matt
Ubu. If you could get like Gothic Bunny, Faye VR, like if you could get like the real content.
You think they're going to work at the fucking maid cafe?
They probably would, actually.
They do have like actual lap dancers at the maid cafe as well. Dancers from other clubs. Like Lost Souls
and COVID-19 and the bomb.
Yeah, I mean, our sister club is Monster Mint, so if you like Monster Mint, you know.
I do like Monster Girls. Fine. I will go by. I will say hi. And I'll see how it goes. Just let me know when it is.
All right, I'll let you know the next event.
You can't stream it, right? So I can't stream it.
No.
Okay.
No streaming.
Vlad and Nox. I'll do it. Make your own Mad Cafe on Kick.
Yeah, I'll DM you.
Cafe on Kick. That does sound fun. All right, thank you.
Not on this guy.
All right, thank you.
Come on, Booger Boys. Come on. Come on, Booger Man. Where's the bomb?
I don't have
the fuck is this?
I had a good weekend. A great weekend because the Pepsi Zero Sugar 400 happened on Saturday and nobody died in that race, so that was cool. Unfortunately, I got COVID-19. Which one of you is COVID?
Well, that's me.
This is COVID-19.
COVID-19.
I fucking hate this thing. Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! Die now. Off this stage.
Oh.
I'm a bit confused by this bit.
Yeah. It's not a bit. This is just my delirium.
Oh, okay.
That was, and then my second bit is J. Robert Oppenheimer. I watched Oppenheimer today while having COVID, and it was pretty cool. It consisted of Cillian Murphy for 3 hours grasping his temples and going, "Oh my god! Oh my god!" And then he had sex, and then that was the whole movie. So I definitely recommend that movie.
What movie? Sorry?
Oppenheimer.
Oh, okay. It's a good movie? I haven't seen it yet. I haven't watched a movie in a long time.
Yeah. Well, Jay, my call-out's for J. Robert Oppenheimer because he spent $2 billion building a bomb and it did not need that much fucking money. I could have built it in less time with less money.
Oh yeah, prove it!
Did you know UFOs can disable nuclear weapons?
This is the bomb. How do you know that?
Because the military's talked about it.
What military?
Our military.
Nah.
It's true.
They would have told me.
God,
I'm yeah? You don't even know anything. No, you don't know what's coming.
This is the nuclear bomb. Come forward, little boy. I don't know, Oppenheimer, I think? It's a pretty good movie. Go watch it. It's like 4 hours long.
Is only Killian Murphy. Should I watch that movie or should I watch Barbie? I'm only going to watch one.
Watch Oppenheimer. No, don't watch both of them. You're going to fucking... You're actually going to die, I think. Especially if you're ill like I was. I walked out of that theater feeling reborn. That shit was horrifying.
Reborn?
It's pretty good, though, I think. Yeah. They had Tony Stark in that movie, too. And Josh Peck and the guy who played Roderick in Diary of the Wimpy Kid. And I think that was pretty cool.
Josh Peck.
Like, did they have... Like, actually, Tony Stark, like, as a character, or did they have Robert Downey Jr.?
They had Robert Downey Jr., but I call him Tony Stark because his name's too long.
Robert Downey Jr. is one of my few man crushes. The only white one.
Mine's Brad Pitt.
I love Brad Pitt.
Troy's what do you think about Brad movie. Pitt?
I like Brad Pitt, too!
What about Ryan Gosling?
I like Ryan Gosling.
Yeah!
He's alright.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, this guy's okay. Maybe I'll start showing up more. This guy likes Ryan Gosling. I'm getting off this stage now. Come on, J. Robert Oppenheimer and Little Boy Fat Man.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Nice.
Hello, Defect. Who's now unbanned?
I have a call out and a shout out.
Okay.
My first call out.
Shoots legs.
Oh, thank you, Neff, for that huge raid.
They both left Legion at the exact same time last night.
Sorry, I got scared.
What were you guys doing?
Dude, there was a lot of people that left at the same time last night. You left at the same time as Aki's mute.
Wait, what the? Worry?
Huh?
Well, Aki's Mori? Second mute, not that one. The other one. The one I don't know that well.
That's my mute friend.
Yeah.
The blue one.
They're nice, actually. They went to that public H party. I got to know them a little bit.
Oh, yeah. Yeah?
Yeah. They're really nice.
Yeah, they're in their natural environment in H party. Makes sense.
Yeah. New mute? Dude, there's too many of them now, chat. Sorry.
And the after party.
They
really
left
fun.
At the same time. Lazzy, did you fuck Turtwig party. Finally?
Oh, yeah.
No.
Okay, thank you. Okay, well...
Why not?
Definitive.
He is a boyfriend.
Oh, I don't
that's
have
a good
the
reason.
The after party was super fun. No. I enjoyed it.
Just because there's a goalie doesn't mean you can't score.
And I was drinking until about 10 a.m.
Okay. Who said that? I'm going to kill you.
Damn. Did you get a shiggity shwasted? I don't know why I just said that.
I did.
That was hip, home slice.
And then I forgot to charge my trackers.
So now you're just a little dusky. Like I'm used to seeing you.
Yeah, you're just pushing 60 years old.
I wanted to fit in with everyone else.
That is true. On Sunday, I don't
so
care if you guys come in desktop mode.
Tonight.
Oh yeah, chat.
Thank you for the sub.
This is a new person that Lazzy brought into DJ Night last night, Tibby. They basically just took off their clothes and started dancing, and it was pretty epic, so I added them to friends.
Yeah.
I don't know anything else about them.
They signed to me, so that was cool. I like sign.
Well, okay, and if you can speak sign language, that's pretty epic. Dude, drunk gothic bunny is unlike anything I've ever seen, actually. It's like, they actually went ultra fucking... They actually went Super Saiyan mode last night. It was actually insane. They should just drink before... They should become an alcoholic and just drink
after
before
left.
Every stream.
Oh, what do you mean? She's
left. She continued on for about another 30 minutes.
I know, because she came on Discord and was, like, talking to us while doing whatever the fuck she was doing in that channel. Or in that lobby.
No, I have COVID.
She was sitting there and watching us, watching me play League of Legends while dancing for people. I was like, what the fuck is going on?
Is that a sickle soul joke?
I don't even know what that means.
Oh, sorry to interrupt. I didn't bring Tibby in. Someone else brought them in. I don't bring people in. But they are a lazy, chatter. So, they're another lazy viewer. But I didn't bring them in. I don't bring people in.
Well, I thought you brought them into D-Gen Night. I'm sorry.
The only person you brought in was...
Yeah, I don't plus one people because they end up here, so...
Oh, yeah, if you want to be here, we're going to have to talk about that later. We'll figure that out. You have to do the tryout. Dun-dun. Another tainted mute. Chat, not every mute that likes Lazy is tainted, okay?
I'm doing, like, air quotations with my hands.
Most of the mutants in the lobby
are on the
track. Also, what is this fascination with you guys like claiming mutes are from your communities when they come in? I'm calling out Aki, I'm calling out Lazy, dude.
I'm not Lazy.
I heard an argument. Hold on, one second, because this is a quick call.
Okay. Your turn. Okay.
I hung out with Gummy a little bit, like recently, you know, because Gummy's been in the lobby, Gummy's been at DJ night and stuff.
Gummy!
I'm going to leave if you do that one more time. I it's actually driving me fucking insane. Okay. And, I brought up a DJ, I'm like, this is a pretty sick mute. And then, Aki comes in, is like, that's a herd member. That's a herd member. And Gummy's like, I'm not a herd member. And Aki got Aki got so fucking pissed. I've never seen Aki so mad. That when Aki was like, dude.
What is a herd member?
Aki was so pissed that they weren't a herd member. Anyone who thinks that they've came from any community, wrong. Trust me. Probably. Who knows?
Exactly.
But it was funny.
I've never come from a community. I come from people.
Aki, you got pretty passive aggressive there.
I hate them. Every single one of them.
You should just disband the herd. It never should have happened to begin with.
Fuck.
This is it. I'm disbanding the herd. It is over. From now on, I'm never streaming again.
What does the herd and streaming have to do with each other?
Well, they're like,
can't stream without the herd?
Community?
Yeah, but you can get rid of the herd without getting rid of your stream.
That wasn't a complete sentence.
We should watch out for my
right. I'm sexual will still be there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dude, it took everything in my power not to start clapping and going, duh, duh.
It's all chat.
Oh my gosh.
I'm not talking about her fucking chat. I'm talking about the parasocial herd. The fucking parties, the group hangouts, that fucking herd. That herd needs to die in a fire.
Fuck you. Yeah, no, I'm skipping dinner.
Why not put him in the slaughterhouse?
Are we killing cows?
Good one, Vincent! Yes, actually. We're eating good tonight, chat.
Burger.
Alright. Go ahead.
And you know what?
I almost did.
Now that we're on the talk of... I agree. Fuck Akiwu. My first call out is for Akiwu. I agree. I'm glad you started us on this. Now I can go in next. Aki, yesterday I was having a wonderful time observing your stream happily in my chair. And it was very enjoyable. As a parasocial herd member myself, I was quite enjoying myself, jerking off to you and imagining what it'll be like when we meet up at TwitchCon. And unfortunately, not only have you decided to ruin your stream with World of Warcraft, you also ruined my parasocial dream love by getting super worked up and simping over some other person, some other streamer, for like 3 hours. And being a gay man, it was really just like, I'm just watching you les out all over this fucking meow girl who's just making you bark on stream is ridiculous. So that's my call out for Aki. She sat there and was barking for this other streamer that she found in the category. And I was losing my mind watching this down bad Sahara Desert cow get all fucking moist over this person.
It was really funny, though. It was really funny. Come on, it was
good? So... I gotta see it.
They weren't even a VR chat person. It was an IRL girl. Like he was just hanging in their chat.
Never somehow touched VR chat. It was weird.
Actual IRL
I don't even know how
girl.
You found their stream. Yeah, they were sitting there barking and stuff.
They barked every sentence. It was insane.
I got to watch Aki horny post in their chat and then invite them to VR chat and then Riz them up and now they're dating. I can't wait.
I mean, yeah, bring new people in. It's been a lot of new people coming in lately. I actually like them all. I'm bringing Bookie in because I think Bookie is a content machine.
Playing hooky, awesome. Hooky, playing hooky with Bookie. Okay, I like them. They stepped on Vincent the first time I met them and he cried. My next call out. Hold on, let me flip through my pages. My next call out is for Morinus Anus Canadius the Third, Maury. I'm calling you out. I am sick and tired of trying to enjoy your streams while you consistently just flirt with this Stitches Aki Mute, walking them around on a leash, pet playing with them,
true,
taking them all over the place and dominating them, whatever. I come to your stream to watch you play Tarkov. Stop flirting with these mutes. It's pissing me off.
When you took me into the back yesterday, you told me I was your only pet. Were you lying to me?
Nuclear world.
Were you playing with my heart?
What is this timeline?
He didn't. What does that even mean?
The drama.
Okay.
Did you betray me? They seem nice, though. I had a nice time with them at H Party last night.
She's stealing my dog. That's my dog.
Yeah, that's.
What the hell?
No offense, Aki. I don't think you're dominant enough to keep them entertained. Oh. They are putting a stray on your name.
I don't know how many strays you leash up and walk on your stream. That's all I'm saying. I tuned in. I didn't go finding it.
One of these fucking humps gotta have rabies.
It's fine. You know what? It's fine. You know, and maybe like the three of us can hang out together sometime, and it'll be really nice at H Party.
It's gonna be sick.
And me too, right?
Hold on, Aki. We're doing something. 1 second. Just wait in line. What were you saying, Crumpet?
Okay. True. I was talking. My next call was going to be how I had to pay a Qantas Airlines flight attendant about $3,000 to prevent Aki Wu from being able to go to TwitchCon with her voucher that she received from Twitch. That was going to be the next thing I said. But that's a huge in joke.
This is my. I'm adding on to this. Fuck Qantas. Okay, thank you.
I don't know what Qantas is.
Qantas is fuck Aki.
It's an airline?
It's basically a flight.
I'll explain it because in jokes are cringe if you don't understand them. So basically, Aki Wu won because she's Australian and Australian Twitch wants. She's like the biggest Australian streamer, basically, or like top 10. So they had this like Twitch Australia like award sweepstakes for getting subs. And Aki did it, and she filled out all the goals, and they gave her $1,000 voucher for a plane ticket to TwitchCon. And then she tried to book it with the flight voucher that they gave her, which was an airline called Qantas based out of Australia. And they basically said, fuck you, Aki, that's not going to work, go fuck yourself. And then she spent like 3 days desperately trying to get TwitchCon tickets and getting fucked over consistently. And then cried about it on stream and not making fun of her for it.
Yeah.
Who cares? Just don't even go to TwitchCon. Who cares about the event itself? It's all about hanging out with the people around TwitchCon.
I mean, yeah. True. I want to meet my friends.
I get to meet my friends.
TwitchCon, I'm avoiding the convention probably completely unless I have to do a meet and greet. Fuck lines.
Are you going to go,
Rob? Smelly ass people. I might go. I don't know. If I go...
Yeah, well, I'm going. So if you go to the convention, you should go with me. Because I'm fun at conventions.
I will gladly go with you. You're the one that doesn't like hanging out with me.
Fuck you. You hang out at 4 a.m. What the hell? I hang out with you every day.
I can actually network you. I can actually introduce you to the big streamers. We could go to fucking Mr. Beast party together. And I could introduce you to everyone as my gay internet boyfriend.
All right. Well, if you want me to suck Mr. Beast's dick to get him to eliminate, then I'll do it. Because I'm a good friend.
Alright, good. Look nice.
Alright, cool.
Okay, could you meet Mr.
Alright, I'll get some makeup. Maybe he'll think I'm Asmongold, so he'll be more likely to let me suck his dick. No. Be like, oh, this young is sick. Oh my god, play a lot of WoW.
Try to look as
Ooh.
Much like Asmongold as possible, and we could, I could just say, this is my friend Asmongold with me. Oh my god, that freaked me out.
Dude, that's like going to Six Flags and having your friend pretend to have cancer so you can skip the lines. That's like the level that we're at. Oh, I'll just pretend to be Asmongold, and then we can skip all the lines.
Where I'll give you one of my OTK t-shirts.
I dance.
Yeah, I got this, bro. I don't know any WoW stuff, but I can pretend. Baki streamed WoW for 48 fucking hours straight. I'm sure I picked up something through osmosis.
Dude, I could imagine the situation right now. I'm like, hey, Chance, come meet up with me and Crumpet. And then we go. And then fucking Chance brings Asmongold. And Asmongold and Crumpet both see each other. And then they look exactly the same. And they stop and just stare at each other. And they both point at the same time and match each other's movements.
It'd be the Spider-Man meme. Dude, me and him couldn't, like, contact each other. We'd atomize each other from, like, being in the same reality.
That's true. Ash, stop letting people cut you in line. What are you doing? Stop letting people cut you. All right.
Well, I was like 6
minutes. I've had a DM from
Ash my next
for
call
like
out.
Over like fucking 6 minutes. And now there's all these other people in line, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna get ready to read Ash's message soon. And then I look, and they're like at the back of the line again somehow.
Pussy
okay,
ass
sorry,
rat.
Go ahead.
Rat pussy. Ooh, rat pussy. Gross. We'll stick with pussy
rat
ass
pussy
rat.
Hit
oh, yeah, my next. Oh my god, it's cheesy. I have a call out for. What's his name? June B. I have a call for June B, who was in Ascension Academy yesterday, and I really enjoyed it. That was very fun.
Can you guys learn how to clip stuff? Yeah. Every fucking clip with June B is just June B, like, walking. And I'm like, what the fuck am I looking at here? Like, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, there is a lot of walking. Just wobbling
along. Well, I actually wanted to see Jumbi do Ascension Academy, and all I saw was Jumbi fucking wobbling around. I'm sure there's more to it than that.
Yeah, there is. It was really funny. I got to play as Jumbi's like patron god, and so they just like it's basically Impractical Jokers, and I can tell them to do stuff. And watching Jumbi try to be mean to people while I'm telling them what to do is really funny because Jumbi hates being mean, and it's like a serious RP. So he'll walk up and like be an elf supremacist to some poor little RPer or bother Curry Games, and Curry's starting to growl, going, "Oh, you again." And then Jimmy's like, oh, okay, we'll be best friends, I'm sure. It's really funny.
Where's Jimmy?
Shout out Jimmy, I like that.
Curry Good Games time. Is going to try to fuck you, like 100%. That man is horny
That's
as
true.
Fuck. Unless you want to, yeah, unless you want that. Yeah. Unless you want that, I would avoid him off stream.
He's so horny. It's so funny. Oh
He's
my god.
So horny.
Yeah, that made me want to do serious RP again. So I begged Chips. Actually, I didn't beg. I walked up to him at DJ Night and I said, let me on Ascension Academy or I have a bomb. And then he said, okay. And I will be a special guest at some point. And I do plan to fuck it up for everyone. So Uzu, watch out. I'm going to RDM your character. I will kill you. It is metagaming. You cannot stop me.
Why?
Okay. Those are my shout outs and call outs. Thank you.
What did
Please
I
do?
Kill Uzi
first.
Wait,
get
can
Uzi
I
first.
Can
yeah.
I join the I've done Ascension Academy
yeah.
before. I've experienced.
Yes, you
do. We should do that. That'd be so fun.
Okay.
I'm serious up here.
I'll do it. I'll join. I'll join.
That actually sounds so fun.
What days are they?
You go to a special episode. It's that Saturday, like 2 hours before DJ night.
No, fuck that. I'm not going on a Saturday. I literally refuse to go to a fucking serious RP on a weekend. That's when your life has really
gone
downhill.
Come on, bro. It's just like an hour. You don't want to go harass the serious RPers. It'd be funny. It'd be funny.
On Saturday?
Stop heading me.
You don't want to spend. You don't want to spend your like. 9 to 11 p.m. on a Saturday, serious RPing with the gang at AA. Come on, bro.
Okay, if I could play an alcoholic that pre-games, okay, that could be fun.
You can.
That's already what they're doing. There's
everyone does.
Dude, everyone hates serious RP so much that they have a meme in AA that's been around for like years where they just call it Alcoholics Anonymous instead of Ascension Academy because every single person in the entire RP is drunk by the third hour.
Why don't they just fucking do something fun then? Like, why are they forcing themselves to do this? Every time I talk to anyone about it.
Because it's so funny.
It's better
funny.
To keep it a secret.
They're all so serious. I love it. Oh my god, dude. It's so funny.
I genuinely have fun there. I don't know.
Yeah, well, you know what, Uzu? I'm gonna kill your character, and there's nothing you can do to stop me. I will power game you to death.
I'm blocking you. I'm blocking you.
Oh, fuck.
You can't block him, Serious RP. You can't block him, Serious RP.
You
can't block him, Serious RP.
I'm blocking everybody. I'm blocking
you. You can't block him, Serious RP. That's minus one.
That's true. Yeah, minus one, Uzu. That's fucked up. You don't have that level of spell casting yet. What the hell?
Maybe if you suck some cock.
But yeah, that was it. I had fun at DJ night last night. Going sober's been nice. I can usually remember things, and I have a pretty good time. I should dance more. That's about it. I had a really fun time with everyone.
Yeah, where's my dance?
Is there anything else? Yeah, I should probably give you one. I haven't given anyone dances in a long time. I'm sure I can manage. Yeah, I gotta get in the groove again. Woo!
Get to work.
Have anything else I want to call out? Shout out Genesis and Vray, cutest lobby couple.
True.
Other than that, fuck Aki Woo, and I hope that streamer she finds fucks her too. Peace. I'm out.
Okay,
let's go.
I'm not even gonna say. Someone linked me a clip of this person. I, for the sake of niceness, I'm going to avoid my opinion on this. Okay. I am going to.
She wants me to take her to a pet store and put her on a leash. IRL at Vegas.
Let's go.
I'm just going to say.
Yeah.
I'm throw up in my mouth.
I'm going to say that the standards for you guys are a little different than the standards for me. Okay. All right, Navish, come on down.
I love insane women.
My turn.
Hello. I have a call out. For a certain individual who has been MIA for 2 weeks. Schleid Denims.
That's a good point. Where is Schleid Denims?
I don't know.
He
but...
died in a dog pouch.
What happened to him? He's gone he's right now.
Oh.
It was a shock collar incident. The issue is. With his absence, someone had to take the role of the bitch at DJ Night who got bullied.
I see.
And I don't want to be in that role, so I need Schleid to come back.
So who has I'll been... So have you been taking that role? You want to get bullied?
He's getting serenaded by Mori. He's complaining.
I volunteer as tribute.
You're complaining about being harassed.
Why are you being bullied?
Maurice.
I volunteer.
Yeah, this guy's a fucking loser. That dude next to me is a loser.
I'm not a loser, I'm a switch, and I'm down to get dominated.
This guy next to me is a sub and a loser.
Right now, are you willing to get a shock collar so we can shock your balls?
No.
What the fuck is going on right now?
Not you guys. Yeah, not you guys, but other people.
That's the terms of it, Eternal.
Eternal, can I ask you a serious question? If you could have one person dom you, who would it be?
In the lobby?
Lich bait.
Yeah, probably. Someone I know, preferably.
I need the code. And Lich bait for sure.
Really? All you would have to do is ask with Lich bait. Like, Lich bait would do it in an instant.
He paid $50 to get his ball stepped on by Lich bait. This guy's a fucking fan.
That is true.
No.
It's the best $50 I've ever spent.
You could have saved $50 and just said, hey, can you step on my balls? And they would have done it in an instant.
Yeah, but sometimes you gotta give money to the queens, you know what I'm talking
about?
So
you like to be financially dommed as well.
Absolutely not, but I only do it for Lich Bait.
I see. Okay. 2023 yeah. Lobby. Chat, come on, man, let people enjoy themselves. You know?
It wasn't even like a sexual thing or anything, it's just the shot caller getting bullied. It's not even anything
weird. It will be for me.
No, yeah, it would be for you. Yeah, that's true.
Okay.
It was just funny. I couldn't make fun of
I have a call out or a shout out too.
Okay, go ahead.
Unless you have something to say.
Well, I was gonna say I was gonna say imagine Mori, right? But Mori shows up to DJ Night in full body wearing some new avatar I've never seen before that's like super hot. And then walks up to you with like with that fucking face tracking, gives you some fucking like look, and then ties a collar around your neck and says, "Come with me." How many of you guys would go with Mori? Okay, this is the
Thank
point
you,
I'm trying to make. I'm willing to bet 90% of you guys would go instantly.
Not me.
Mori is different.
No, I wouldn't.
Mori is very different. Anyone else in the lobby? I probably wouldn't care.
Cam won't go in an instant. You become a mute.
That's fucking Cap. No, I wouldn't. What?
No, you're right. It is Cap. You wouldn't mute. You'll start meowing instead.
Man, shut your bitch ass up.
XCon just pwned you, which is like a double pwn.
Bitch ass motherfucker.
Dude, XCon's... XCon's
the... How are we sticking strays?
XCon's on the up and up, dude. He's been working on his confidence lately. He's been making call-outs.
Fuck you, Uzu.
Ever since he lost that dance battle, he's been working on his redemption arc.
I'm just playing WoW.
I'm playing WoW over here. I'm that guy.
Oh, yeah, shout out.
The trick is...
shout
go
out.
Ahead.
Oh.
Sorry, you go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. I'm going to stop interrupting.
Let me off the stage, please. Shout out to the Joey Chestnut of Eating Calm broadcast. That is all.
Yo.
That's true.
I forgot I said that. Yeah.
Holy shit.
That phrase is going to be stuck in my head for a month, dude.
Yeah, we love you to come here.
I won't elaborate.
I have no rebuttal.
Something
I did say
that. Happening between you two.
What? What do you mean, you two?
I slowly back away now.
Okay.
This is the newest, latest couple in the lobby.
Okay, bye.
Wait, what? Okay, see you later. Nice to meet you again. We'll have to talk about stuff.
Alright,
we'll talk later. Okay. Alright. Listen, chat, very important call-out. The most important call-out, okay? Please, if you like the kick streams, please do not DM me and say, you looked so hot dancing, I lost. I don't want to know. I'm going to stop doing kick streams.
Welcome to my life, Rob.
That's awesome.
And here's the part that bothers me, is I said this last time. I told you guys I don't want to know, and then someone else messaged me and said, you said people messaged you they lost to you during that kick stream. ... yeah, I did as well. I don't want to know. Call them out? Well, I usually close them instantly. This is the only one I haven't... Fine, you know what? I usually close them instantly, but I was just looking at my message request and I was like, oh my god, fuck. All right, here, Ash, I'm going to use you as a placeholder so I could show the screenshot.
Murder crumpet.
Hold on. All right, fine. But then people are going to start doing this in hopes of getting called out. But I'll do it. Fuck it. I'm calling this one out, all right? I'm using you.
Once.
I'm only doing this once. All right? Here we go. Hold on. This? I don't want to see this in my DMs, chat. I don't want to see this. All right? Don't say this.
Because he wants to see more of it.
Start DMing this guy more about how you come to him.
That
come
guy jerked
guys.
Off to you and came. A man jerked off to you and come.
Stop. I'm never doing a kick stream again.
This man is begging to be told about how many people have come.
This chat.
You're a gay porn star.
Chat. You sent me something? Okay. This is one of the reasons. You guys want to know why the kick streams I do in desktop mode? This is one of the reasons. This is one of the reasons. All right. Eternal, get out of my DMs. hold on, Speedy. Oh, this is nice. Yeah, thank you, Speedy. That's a 9.5 out of 10. Okay. Remember, guys, if you send me a screenshot or GIF of yourselves, I will rate it out of 10. Okay. Hi, Ash. You finally made it here.
Wait, for real?
Yes. Yeah, that's a thing that I've been doing lately.
You want another
come on.
So far, Nayuki's the only one who's gotten a 10. Alright. Let's see here. Ash says... Oh yeah, I used you as a placeholder for that screenshot. Let me delete that. Okay. I have a call out for myself. You're so nice, you can't even call out someone else. You have to fucking call out yourself. Okay, let's see. I can't remember anything after we played. Never have I ever. And then I, like, time-skipped, and we were playing League? I'm missing, like, 7 hours of my life. I don't know what happened, but I guess L for me. Okay, so here's what happened. I could tell you, because I think I've seen you a decent amount of times. Okay, so we played Never Have I Ever. You probably drank a lot, because you've never done anything, because you're very innocent. And every time you don't do something and you don't move forward, you have to take a shot. Dude, and then I had to sit there and fucking listen to fucking Surefour. I'm not gonna move forward. I never do anything. I'm gonna stay here on the first one. Okay? I don't even know why I'm playing the game because I'm gonna stay here. That. And I'm like, oh my god. Alright. Anyway.
You sound like a Simpsons character.
So yeah, and then you started showing some people your dance moves. Like, you were doing, like fucking some pretty cool shit, actually, for a drunk person. You know, you were doing some pretty cool shit on the stage. And then I think you started giving a dance but got shy. And you were like, oh, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm so bad. And then stopped. And then we played League, and we actually dominated League for the first time in forever. I don't know what changed last night, but last night we were fucking owning League. Like, that was fun. Probably because I destroyed top every single game, except for that last game against that York, which I'm not going to talk about. Did we play with Keo? No, we didn't. It was a pretty fun night. Oh, shit. Watch out, there's a cat attacking you! Holy shit! I typically would try to save Ash, but this is just too...
Not like this.
Too good to look at, honestly.
Look at them.
Crazy if there was like a mud
ecosystem. Well, chat, what ends up happening is every time we play League, whoever's top ends up fucking losing horribly, and then the fucking other top laner just ends up at our inhibitor turret at the fucking in 12 minutes in. But that didn't happen last night because I was top and I was shitting on people, except for Yorick, which I won't talk about. All right, now you're up here. You want to hug it out? Oh, I have a new outfit. I made it from scratch. All it will cost is the low price of 20 giftas, and I'll show it off. Okay, guys, for some giftas, there's a lot of good outfits we could see, okay? At 5K, you guys can see Mori's new outfit, which is super hot, actually. I lost so hard when I saw it. Holy shit, that outfit is actually insane. And then you can see Mika's for the low price of 20. I think Jufa has something too, right, Jufa? There's a lot going on here. All right.
Would you guys consider boy pussy to be pussy?
Yes.
Congratulations, yes. This guy. You got the first two in your screenshot. Thank you, DFG, for the tenor. Halfway there. But let me know who you're giving it to, because there's different people that have goals. So if that's towards the Mika fund, I need to know. Mika, 10. All right, Mika, you've gotten the first 10. All right. So there's a probability says we're probably gonna go on a date next week. Wear something nice. Can you resub from her? No, resubs do not count. It's gifted subs. All right, thank you, Mika. Wink, say you. Hello, Lazzy.
Would you guys consider boy pussy to be pussy? RP guard down a little bit here. Yes. As you can tell, there's not 85 random monsters behind me doing a dumb bit.
You guys have a proposition for fucking disbanded.
Worse. I have a proposition for your chat. For 100 subs, the Citizens will not do their call out today. Alright? For 200, we'll just leave the lobby today. We'll just go home. Yeah, so if you give us 100 subs, dedicated to us, we won't do our call out. But if not, we have 8 call outs that are going to be really cool and really badass and really clever, and we did a lot of work for it, and it'd be like really upsetting if we did that, you know? So,
do you think they secretly want to see it? I actually think chat secretly wants to see your guys' callouts.
We did put a lot of work into it, so.
Did you put a lot of work into it, or are you just saying that to extra bait? Plus, guys, remember, if the Tizards get the most subs, I have to go on a date with them in the next week. So maybe, considering
all of
like
us,
they
all
want.
All 10 of us.
Yeah, all of them. Dude.
And so.
Would we do it on Kick or on Twitch? Right. Which one would you want? I'll let you choose.
Half of us on Kick, other half on Twitch. Alright.
I'm not having two fucking dates with you guys. How much time of mine do you want?
Wait, I have a question.
Yes, Turwig.
If the Tizards win it, could we just do like a Tizards boys night on Kick?
We could do that. If that's what you guys want.
He's just saying that because he wants to leave next to you and get a bunch of lap dances. It's not actually RP.
That's not true.
Wait, Rob, what happens after the date?
Wait, that's true for me, though. That's true for me.
Every date is ended the same way.
True for me, too. You would have to fuck all the Tizards.
Alright, well, we didn't get the subs, so you know what this is. Alright, guys, get over here. Come on, guys. Come on.
Miss that tenor? What, the tenor from Crickles? Sorry, he started talking. Crickles, thank you for that tenor. Who's that tenor for? Did you write?
I've got the timer.
Okay, Mika. He wants to see the outfit before this bullshit. You did hit the 20, and you are in the lead with 20 baited subs. I got you, Crickles. 20 subs to mute the tizzards. I could do... See, you could have baited that harder. You could have been like 10 subs to bait them each. Doomsday Maverick raid? Holy, thank you, Doomy. Appreciate that, Doomy.
Doomy? Why'd you say it like that?
Yeah, the way he said
it. Because I have mental illness. That's why I said it like that. Is that a Jufa? That is a Jufa. Wait, that's really cute. I like that. You made that yourself? Yeah, I like that a lot. That is actually a really cool outfit. Do a little twirl. Oh shit, we're ready for our racing arc. Card dealer.
I'm gonna kill you.
Dude.
You start this? This started before. I will take this under my belt though, because NASCAR meta's happening.
Dude, honestly, I would if I could take credit for that outfit and be like, yo, I started that meme, I would take credit for it. Mika looks good. I like it. Do you have like a slight tilt in your top? I noticed. I was looking at your boobs. Defect! I see you, Defect!
Me too.
Thank you for the 20 bomb. Let me know what that 20 bomb is towards. That's for the tizzards?
Why would you do this? Why would you do this? Why?
Okay, guys. Tizzards are now tied with Mika Moonlight for the date.
That's terrible.
But Mika!
Thank you, Mika Moonlight. You look amazing. Thank you for showing off this sick new outfit. I can't wait to start racing. My heart is already racing.
Aww, thanks for the
fiver.
You're such a good boy.
God. Tizards, you guys are up.
Yes.
I mean, we're last an hour.
Super Ninja! Thank you for the primer. Go ahead, Lazzy.
Can I do the... All right, ladies and gentlemen, I know you guys have been complaining about these weak callouts, lame callouts. Well, me, Scientist Man 22, have developed the best programming simulation for the best machines of all time and for the best robots. I didn't say the gun stage yet.
Didn't you have a 20 bait too, Jufa? What was yours?
And so.
No, keep going. Restart. Oh my god, dude.
Yeah, restart.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's me, Scientist Man 22. I'm here doing our call out bit. And we've programmed the best call outs from all the best generations. We've combined chat, lobby, AI generation.
You're such a good boy.
And all kinds of stuff to give you the best call outs the world has ever seen.
Okay, he didn't start
These
over.
Are really high quality. Beep boop, I summon the bots to the stage.
I'm gonna be honest, when I saw you in that and I saw this, from far away I thought that was Gordon. Like, he kinda has the same color scheme as Gordon Freeman. I thought this was gonna be a halfway bit.
No, we're too dumb for that. Y'all gotta light up. Alright, first off, I summon,
Alright, 5 more for Mika, that brings Mika up to 30.
Yeah, shit, Mika.
You're not stupid enough to be a tizzard, coward. First off, I bring out a shark bot. Get up here.
Hold on. Defect, was your 20 to mute the tizzards? If so, you have to pick which one I mute.
Defect is a tizzard support.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you can mute discount.
Oh, okay.
Alright, here's Sharkbot with his call out. And this is an AI generated perfected call out just for this lobby. Hit him with it.
Yo dog, I'm Sharkbot, you know. I was really chumming the waters of AI, you know, because I'm a shark.
Yep.
So I got my call out. So let's go ahead and take a bite into this, you know, because I'm a shark. The night started off as most nights do. We were all walking through the halls of VR chat and talking about how we wanted to fuck some sexy anime girls and how much we wanted to see them suck our fat cocks. But we were also but you're also talking about how much we hate furries and how they won't stop trying to fuck us. Mori, who is a huge bitch and a cunt, said the furries were gonna murder us and our families. But I think that's but I think it's a bunch of bullshit, because furries aren't capable of leaving their basements. As we were talking, a mysterious hooded figure approached us and told us that he had an offer. This person, who we would later discover was Rob Malecki, asked us to kill someone for him, and if we didn't, he would tell everyone about our secret desire to have sex with mutes. I was so scared, because the secret about me being a mute fucker was only supposed to be between the members of the Golden Gator community, a sex drama lobby. If Rob spilled the beans to everyone, then our world would know that the Tizzards are mute fetishists.
This is true.
So,
this is all
we accept the task. He said that the person we're supposed to kill was Jufa, but Jufa wasn't really a person. She was actually an eldritch demon that had been secretly stalking and watching our every move. This creature, who is also a mute, has taken the form of a hot anime girl in order to infiltrate our ranks and learn the ways of the humans. She's been watching us for quite a while, and now it's time for her to make her move. I was worried that we'd not be able to kill Jufa, but I have only ever seen one mute, and that was when I was young. But I've heard tales of their incredible sexual power and how they can bend the will of lesser creatures.
I didn't know
the stories say the only way to defeat a mute is to fuck it in submission, but I don't know if that's true or not. We started searching for Jufa. We looked all over VRChat, but we couldn't find her anywhere. And after a while, we gave up and decided to go home.
Thank you, Sharkbot. You can go back now.
Thank you. That is, yeah, thank you. The peak of AI, guys. Thank you. Beep boop.
Did anybody write that down?
Next up is a bot somebody of you guys know so well. You guys really relate to. We put this bot through a lot of call-outs, and it just got really depressed. So this is a depressed bot. Sad bot. Get up here.
You can't shit talk about that story being AI generated because they're literally an AI bot. Like, it's lore. It's literally lore.
Yeah. This is sad bot.
Beep boop.
I can see myself.
I can see the most depressed person in the lobby on my screen. Beep boop. Beep.
Sure. Uh-oh. Well, it's been a... You know what? It's been a decent week for me, so maybe not. But soon. Probably.
You are wrong. I am right. And now I have a story.
Okay.
It's a lore dump, you know. Becoming entangled in the Tizzards group within VRChat was a descent into a sorrowful spiral. What initially appeared as a lighthearted endeavor centered around observing mutes transformed into a relentless obsession, succumbing to base desires and eclipsing the meaningful connections and personal growth I once cherished. As the days past, the laughter and camaraderie that initially blossomed around shared experiences with the mutes masked a growing emptiness, leading to the isolation from dear friends who couldn't comprehend my immersion into a shallow existence. The group's shallow pursuits revolving entirely around mutes became my identity, causing the erosion of my aspirations and dreams. Are you listening?
Yeah.
Okay, and a haunting sense of detachment settled in. This journey illuminated the harsh reality of losing oneself in the pursuit of instant gratification and fetishized interactions, highlighting the fragility of genuine relationships and underscoring the importance of navigating the virtual realm with discretion. Regrettably, the aftermath left me not only with a lack of purpose and disconnect, but also stripped the ability to bring joy through humor, as my interactions now seem tragically confined to a singular hollow focus on being horny for mutes. Ahem. Guys, only like 20 more subs and we'll stop the callouts, guys. Or how many? 80? 80 more subs and we stop callouts?
80, yeah, like
80 more subs and we literally stop callouts. Thank you.
Good job, Beep Boop. Alright, next up. Alright, this bot is a very special one. I put a lot of work into this one. You know, this lobby's had a lot of callouts. Some of them good, most of them bad. And
that
I collected them all into one source.
Was, this guy sucks. That's so funny.
Well, this bot is a collection of all the lobby callouts put through an AI generator. Alright, so come out, lobby bot. Come out here, lobby bot. Show what you got.
Beep boop. Believe it and shit. Beep boop. I've compiled all the callouts of the past 4 weeks and created a detailed picture analysis. Sending now.
Okay. Thank you, discount. Unmute. Well, shit. That would go against the 20 bomb. Okay, hold on. What the fuck am I watching right? Am I looking at right now? Alright, hold on. This is the first screenshot I was given. Oh wait, that's not it.
Oh, that was for my rating. That's RP card down. That's for my rating.
Okay, there you go. Leaked? What, my fucking dashboard? Here, you guys can see it again. Who cares? Alright, here we go.
Yeah, what do you rate that one, by the way? Could you rate that before RP?
Oh, that was your rating picture?
Did I get a live rating? Yeah, that was my rating picture.
That's a 7 out of 10.
Fuck yeah. Take that discount.
This is the picture you wanted to show? The second picture is my picture now. Cat?
Yep, it's a... compiled all of everyone's callouts, and that's what came out of the ChatGPT.
Okay. I'll show it. There you go, chat.
Cute! Oh my god, he's so fat!
Meow! That's me.
Crumpet loves fat things. Maybe that's why Crumpet likes me. Sorry, go ahead.
You better stop losing weight.
Now I'll be generating the best of the best callouts of the past 4 weeks in an all-time rendition, beep boop and shit. I'm upset. Someone generating callout. I'm upset. Someone put me low on a tier list. They said I was stinky. I'm not stinky. I'd also like to bring up the maid cafe. Haha. We should go to the maid cafe, Rob, sometime. Winky face. Haha. Generating crumpet callout. J-Rose, mute fucker! J-Rose, mute fucker! Bone kick the tits, mute fucker! DJ Knight was really fun last night. Insert inside joke here that chat wouldn't understand.
Oh, shit.
I watched Oppenheimer yesterday. It was good.
That was broadcast call out.
Final call out.
Today!
Loading the... only funny call out in the past four weeks. Eric, loading. I don't usually get on stage too often, but me and Lisa have decided to unpartner.
That was longer than 4 weeks ago. Get your time right.
That is true. That is the last interesting thing that the Tizzards have said, yes.
When you make an hour long call out every All right. week, you know, your brain rots.
Oh, fuck. All right, what was that one? Okay, that's let's bring out this one. It's human bot. Yeah. Come here. Yeah, just that's you.
Hi, Chalupa.
Me? Me? I'm a human bot. Hi.
Hey.
As you may know, I have studied humans and saw your emotions like niceness and generosity and viciousness and war. And I found that humans love to complain. And that's what I'm going to do. First, I would like to call out SeviDude and their rotation of mutes lately every week. SeviDude, the true maestro of platonic mute partnerships. Your uncanny ability to rotate through mute companions on a weekly basis is nothing short of spectacular. Bravo! Gather round, everyone, and witness the legend of SeviDude, who hops from mute partner to mute partner like a nomad seeking the world's most silent oasis. Your commitment to short-lived conversations is almost inspiring, if not incredibly bizarre. SeviDude, your talent for forming fleeting friendships based on mutual silence is truly a marvel. While others build bonds through shared interests, you're forging connections in the most unconventional way by saying absolutely nothing. Keep on with your mute rotation adventure, SeviDude. As the rest of us revel in dialogue and camaraderie, you're gallivanting through the world of VR chat, leaving a trail of temporary non-interactions in your wake. You've truly mastered the art of being present by being absent. I have another call out for Lazzy.
Okay.
As he is gatekeeping during RP.
Okay.
Lazzy, the gatekeeping sentinel of VR chat RP. Your exceptional talent for ruining the role-playing party while simultaneously putting the Tiz and Tizzard is quite the feat. Bravo! Gather round, fellow RP enthusiasts, and meet Lazzy, the connoisseur of condensation. and the Grandmaster of Grumpiness.
Don't laugh, you're a robot.
I am a human bot! Humans laugh, you dick! Your mastery of reminding us of the self-appointed role as the RP Sheriff is truly remarkable. I would like to take this time to remind everybody, at 80, with 80 more subs, I will walk off the stage. Like a symphony of sour notes in the world of imagination. Lazzy, your knack for sucking the fun out of RP like a vacuum cleaner of enthusiasm is nothing short of legendary. While others revel in creative freedom, you are there, diligently ensuring that your personal standards are met, or else. So hats off to you, Lazzy, for reminding us how to be the ultimate RP buzzkill. May your legacy as the gatekeeping maestro continue to inspire eye rolls and chuckles. Here's to hoping your RP compass eventually points toward the realm of lightheartedness.
I don't know what those words mean.
And finally, I have one more call out. And that is the Chuck E. Cheese pizza for tasting like cardboard. You see, Chuck E. Cheese's pizza is a culinary marvel that defies... Yes, there is. I know, there's one around the corner. Marvel that defies taste and texture. A cardboard masterpiece, meticulously designed to make chewing feel like gnawing on an art project gone wrong. Bravo! Your commitment to flavorless adventures are truly commendable, proving that sometimes mediocrity knows no bounds. Pizza emoji, party emoji.
Oh, good job, human bot. Get out of here. You got more personality.
I would like a compliment now. Humans like compliments.
Oh, you gotta wait till the chat part where the chat like does callouts, you know? Like we have that already. You know, that I'm sure they're gonna compliment you, especially after that amazing call out.
I remind chat, 80 more subs, we walk off stage.
That is true.
I don't think they care, dude.
Beep boop. Beep boop.
Alright, this next one's kinda fucked up. I don't know what's wrong with it. It's the pink one. Hey, pink one, can you... Your time for your call-out budget.
You gotta
boop, buddy. Beep-boop,
beep-boop.
Oh, beep. Rob, come here. He's doing his call-out here, I guess.
You want me to... What about all the people around the stage?
Would you guys consider boy pussy
Thanks
to be
that tenor.
Pussy?
Rob, you have to help me, man. You have to help me get about here. Come on.
Beep. My mirror's still here.
Looking
good.
Are the best RPers.
No,
beep
no,
beep.
No, no, no.
Hey, buddy.
Would like beep beep.
It's out there. Outside. On the stage. Wrong way. Yeah. Sorry about that. You know how it is.
Why did you link me a picture of a guy on top of a pole at Krispy Kreme Donuts, butt ass naked?
But you gotta enjoy it.
I just liked it. I thought you'd like it too.
I did like it. It's really funny.
I don't know what he's doing up there.
You have new shorts? How the fuck do you bait a tenor that fast with just shorts? Like, what do you even do? Alright, well, you're at 10.
It's probably because she's wearing them.
You just have to be a conscientious objector.
Beep.
I see.
Beep.
What kind of shorts are they?
Beep.
Go ahead, Sebi. Oh, those are the shorts?
Out.
Aren't those...
Beep.
Are those different?
No,
oh, no, you're swapping.
They're looking at beer.
Beep.
Are they
I don't
just,
know if they're different.
Like
can you get a closer look?
Do they just show more ass?
Beep. Beep.
It's a buff.
Yeah.
Hi.
Beep. DJ Knight should be less nudity. It is disgusting what I see every day. Beep. Beep. I would like to shout out Little Slim for being the best mute in the lobby. His moves are... His moves are immaculate. His vibes are insane. His swag is quite cool. Would like to call out Catman for being best RPer in lobby. Shows up every day when needed. Has best callouts that I've seen every single day. And finally, all the dancers in the lobby. You guys are Thanks. Content machines. Your RP abilities are out of this world. And last but not least, Beep, Maverick, you have the best VR chat stream that I've ever seen. You will make it.
The dancers are actually
and
unironically
everyone
good
who
RPers,
decides And if you decide to join the lobby, just know that you will become the next best streamer that VRChat has ever seen. So please make sure to give 100 subs to me. Beep. Beep.
Match stream today, I literally could care less.
Beep. Call. Beep. Recalibrating. Beep. Call out. Beep. Recalibrating. Beep. Call out.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Beep.
Yeah,
recalibrating.
It goes.
Yeah, no, that was great.
He's still going.
He's so smart.
All right, we got one more. All right, we got one more little robot here. This one's very personal and dear. This one is probably the worst one. But,
even might be the only funny one besides Jacob.
Who's leaving? There's just a bunch of robots back there.
Oh, sorry.
You fucking stupid? Alright, so we got like chat as a whole, and put it through an AI generator, and yeah, that's a chatbot. Get up here. Let's see what you got to say, chatbot. Let's see what chat callouts are like. If chat did callouts, the body is just like chat too, so it works out perfectly.
Wait, Lazzy, you're a member of chat?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess it makes sense.
My glitches is weird.
Loading. Call out. Tizzards. Ew. Tizzards. Ew.
True.
Voting. Shout out. Raise ass.
Why does his mic sound like that? Represent chat, you don't fucking get it, man. This is
dude, Vincent
just
signed.
Call out. Rob! Shut up. Back.
True.
He's not fat anymore.
This is like joke boat, man.
Hey there, guys.
Thank you, D-Fake, for the 50 bombs. What is that going towards?
Mika Moonlight is the best.
Vista is still only like two left.
That's actually fucking massive, D-Fake. You just casually dropped a fucking 50 bomb. Like a G. Do you want that you want that towards the Tizzard? Dude, you want me to go on a date with these people.
Call out.
Yeah, baby. Yes.
He 50.
Yeah, 100 subs will close the game.
50. Please.
He's
done. Where did he go?
Golly gee.
Bravo.
All right. Right. That was chat. As it usually goes, chat just leaves whenever we come up here and start talking. So. All right. I got some myself as the creator. I hope you guys enjoyed the AI generated callouts. We put a lot of work and effort into it. This Friday, Club Kick.
That's true.
Y'all like that, right? Club Kick.
Club Kick this Friday.
If you want to go to Club Kick, let me know.
Are you looking at Jufa?
If you don't DM me, then. Oh, say mean things about you. I'm like looking around, man. I'm like doing like an AoE look. I was like going all around, and like you stop it. Fucking like oh, I can't look at Jufa, huh? I can't fucking look at Jufa. Hey, what up, Jufa? What up? We're playing Resident Evil 5 together later this week, probably. It'll be fun. But yeah, if you want to go to Club Kick, just DM me. There's no theme, so we'll have like 20 something dancers all throwing ass and shit. Should have two new ones, hopefully.
Oh my god. Turwick, that picture is insane. Can I say what you just linked me?
Yeah.
He linked me a picture of you, Lazzy, when you were 12. Holy fuck. There's no way.
What? Okay. There's
no
puberty
way that's you
hit
at 12.
Me really fucking hard. Dude, puberty, Lily, I looked fine, then I was 6'3" and grew out facial hair, and it just, I didn't have many friends. Look, I was a special ed for a reason, man.
How
do you
have a neckbeard at 12? I've never heard of that in my life.
Dude, I told you, puberty literally fucked me up, and that's why they put me in special ed, because I looked like that. They just assumed I was fucking ill. So, 20 subs for it, or
no, you know what? I'm just gonna... I could bait it. I could bait it.
10 subs. 10 subs for the tizzards.
It's literally worse than my fucking mustache picture, if y'all want to know. Worse than my mustache picture.
I will show you it for dude, it's gonna be 10 more subs for the tizzards, but I do need to bait. So, if you want to see 12-year-old Lazzy with a neck beard, just let me know. 10 subs, alright?
Why'd you save that? I sent that to you privately. You saved it. Such a piece of shit, dude. We were sharing like private photos, and he saved that one because he thought it was really funny. Oh,
let me see if I can picture. Let me see if I can find a picture of me when I was young. Like cringely young.
Thanks for the
I was going to go through my Facebook, you're and I found that. And
we should have a day where people just like post pictures of themselves, like embarrassing style. That could be fun.
Yeah.
There's like 5 people here who are willing to show their faces. What do you mean?
Well,
the 5 of us can
fiver.
Do it.
You're such a good guy.
It's literally my profile.
Oh, shit, they did it. Oh, shit.
2 fivers,
that's
expression
2 fivers, right?
Incubator.
Thanks for the fiver. All
right, I go to the tizzards.
You're such
all right.
A good boy.
But yeah, okay, listen, man. High school was really rough for me. Or junior high, fuck me. I didn't have any friends growing up, okay? This picture is why I ended up how I am today, okay?
That makes sense.
We need 20 more.
All my old pictures are just pictures of me from old conventions with, like, I'm a cutie pie and shit.
Mine are that picture you saw.
Okay, here we go. Alright, chat, here you go. Are you guys ready? For the most badass motherfucker you ever gonna see?
Yeah. That's literally no one's ever seen this. I saw the oh my god, this is I'm gonna scream.
Alright, hold on.
Don't get it twisted. This rap is mine. It's really
there's no way you're fucking 12. There's no fucking way. There's no way. That's a 16-year-old. There's no way.
Thanks, guys. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thanks, guys. Thank you. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. I'm in that room right now. Where that bitch is taken, I'm still in that room. Vincent, it's not that funny, Vincent. That's it. Xbox is really cool. I had a beanie.
Kill Vincent.
Vincent free.
I have old pictures
like
of me,
a fat with a little bit of hair on the tips.
Someone just said he looks like Ed from Ed and Eddie.
What the fuck? Thanks, guys. The pussy destroyer. Why'd you name it that?
Oh my god. Oh, come on.
My brother's last. That was the
I only have one, like old picture on my computer of me and my friends. Hold on. Do you guys want to see a chat? Me and my homeboys from back in the day? We can compare it to Lazzy's picture. But I don't know how old we are here. This could be a little bit older. Hold on, let me send it to Turtwig first in a DM and then open it. Hold on, okay, here we go. Hold on.
Damn, that's badass.
This is me and my crew chat back in the day, alright? This is me in my childhood. There's me. This is my friend David. This is Alex, who you guys all have met, you know? This was my homies, dude. Giga Chads. This was my house. Look how shitty my house looks, dude. You look more Polish, what, in this picture? Yeah, pretty much. You got a big-ass head? Because I was super skinny. Remember how I said I had a huge-ass Adam's apple? Look at that shit. Your face has not changed? What does that mean? What does that mean? I look so different. But yeah, this is me and my friend group. See, we were like the kids that bullied fucking Lazzy and his friends. Holy shit, a 50 bomb. Let me know what that's towards.
Thank you guys for the 20 stamps. Yippee!
Babyface, because we're young.
That's a Mika gifter.
Looks like a 2000s boy band? Shut up. Alright, let me accept these invites. Alright, is that it for the Tizzards callouts?
Let's see what else happened.
50 to Mika. Alright, I'm adding it. Adding it. 50 to Mika. That puts Mika at 80.
I had some, but...
over the Tizzards.
What do you want to see fucking Rob going to date with? This or the Tizzards, man? Come on.
Remember how they all end, chat. Remember how they all end.
I will have my clothes off. Also, I sent you a picture, Rob. Could you rate it real quick before I get off stage?
Yeah, sure. Whose butt is that?
The bunny girl who danced on you last night.
Did they seem nice? I mean,
very shy.
I'll give it a 4 out of 10. It's just a
all right, cool.
It's just a butt. There's not really much going on here, but it's decent.
All right. I had a bunch of callouts, but the embarrassment of that photo has ruined me as a person, so I'm getting off the stage. Tizbots, roll out.
33 minutes.
Woo! Yeah!
Hi, Keckle. Good to see you, Keckle. Thanks for the 65.
That's pretty good.
I can get back on stage.
All right, I'm restarting the timer.
I actually like that one. I'm not joking. I like that
I'm
one.
I'm too embarrassed to be funny now.
Pussy Destroyer. That's the guy who said, I fucked your mom over Xbox Live.
That's actually badass.
I don't know why Automod kept that away.
No, fuck you.
All right. Winged Flow, please come forward. That's an emote now? Pussy Destroyer. I just wanted to say, why are you dead? Okay, well, they fucking died instantly. Okay.
Oh. Holy fuck. They're dead.
Oh. Alright, then.
Alright, what's up, discount? Oh, yeah. I have you muted. Yeah, well, I don't know. Defect, you gifted 20 to mute discount. Do you want me to unmute discount?
He's gonna bait 20.
Can you unmute him and then mute him again?
Like, instantly?
Or
like after his call out.
To like 5.
Okay. Alright, here we go. This guy, you have 5 seconds. Go ahead.
5, 4, 3, 2.
He's a bomb. He has a bomb.
I counted 5 in my head. Just because you counted slow doesn't mean I'm gonna like suddenly, you know. Does anyone else have a call out or shout out?
No.
All right, I guess we're going next.
No. That was the worst joke you've ever said.
Pay me money.
Give me money.
Give me money.
Why is this guy still insane?
Give me money.
All right. Well.
$20.
What's so funny?
I can't.
Okay. I have a shout out.
Oh, we gotta get our payout.
I have a shout out for a goddess. Okay, someone who you guys know I've been simping for really hard. Human Whooper Boop, actually. You guys all expected something else, and I fucking jabated you. Alright? Human Whooper Boop is my new call out of the week. And yeah, that was some good content, Whooper. I'm never gonna forget that, alright? You knew it'd be Whooper Boop?
Would you guys consider Rob shoutouts?
Yeah. You don't like them? Alright, well then you can come back in 30 minutes when they're done. Get fucked, loser. Defect, who's that going towards?
What?
Dizzards. Okay, done.
Dizzards! Let's double.
Tizzards are now tied.
Such a fun time, Rob.
Tied with Mika. All right, again at 80. All right, awesome.
Tied up to Mika? Fucking Tizzards are single-handedly getting funded by
DFC Ghost Slayer. That is true.
Wait a second.
Defect, do you have unlimited money? Because it's gonna take that to beat to beat everyone else.
What?
You don't have more than 80.
Defect gifted 80 total, and then Lazzy baited 15 for the picture. So we have 95.
No, didn't Defect pay for the picture, or am I wrong?
No, no, there were like 3 fivers.
Okay, okay, I will fix it. I will fix it. I'll put it up to 95.
Yeah.
Holy shit, did we just hit 5k? Yo, I don't have to bait anymore. Wait, what the fuck just happened? DFG 10, Wraith 10, Nintendo Damata 20? Please let me know what you guys want to put that towards. I will put them all towards where they belong, alright? This might end up becoming a Mika versus Tizzards week, which will be a rough campaign, guys. Will we go on a date with the Tizzards? Will we go on a date with Mika Moonlight? Or will someone else come out of nowhere and bait a bunch? You know? We'll find out. Find out next time on the next exciting episode. Okay, thank you guys for helping me get back over 5k. Maury, oh yeah, Maury, your new outfit. But you should probably show it in full body, not in desktop mode, because that thing looks hot as fuck.
I'm a double agent.
Okay. shout outs. Nice. I want to do some kind of a RP event this Thursday and invite some people. I just don't know what yet, but I'll think of something fun. So probably something fun this Thursday. Again, art showcase next Sunday. Don't forget. It looks like Maury's getting to VR chat to show the thing, the avatar themed RP. I thought Surefour was gonna do
Rob,
date night. Oh
Rob,
fuck, you're right.
Rob,
I think that
I'm
is.
I'm interrupting. Rob.
Okay. Okay.
Rob,
okay.
I'm interrupting.
Okay.
I see. Needs to say.
Okay.
Something.
Thank you. Thank you for not saying something when I said, "Does anyone else have a shout out or call out or anything?" And waiting for this moment where I'm making more announcements. All right. Go ahead.
Sorry, I had to interrupt. Sorry.
Okay. Is Tobe Icy's new talker? What happened? Did J-Rose fuck up?
They want to end their partnership with J-Rose because Icy's boyfriend sent J-Rose a card for her birthday for everybody to sign, and J-Rose did not do that, which is really mean, J-Rose. I don't know where the fuck you are. So she wants to end it with him for being a dickhead.
I actually signed it. That's actually a fucking lie. I 100% signed that.
All right, new interesting call out. Hey, you said there's been no interesting call out.
You're supposed to send it around the Gator community for everybody to sign, but you didn't.
Oh, okay. I didn't know I was supposed to do that. Okay.
J-Rose, you don't care.
Yeah, my bad. No,
I mean, like, I
would,
like,
I didn't know that was what I was supposed to
do.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I feel like it's kind of obvious to get, like, more signatures for her on her birthday card because it's her birthday.
Wait,
I feel like
J-Rose.
It's like a
did
friend or like more awkward
J-Rose?
Thing
did
to
say
do.
Pass it around the Gator?
I mean, it's fine.
Check it. You know, if it doesn't say that, then that's not
it.
I wouldn't have passed it on chat. I honestly hardly ever signed it, if I'm going to be honest, but I'm kind of a dickhead.
Because you don't know if he's already passed it on to other people in the Gator.
Yeah, here you go, Rob.
But okay.
Bad. My bad. Didn't know I was supposed to do that, so my bad. I thought it was hard being passed around. Sorry, I see.
Did you pass it on to Broom and Seth?
Breaking off or what? Yep.
Technically, he did his job, but I mean,
all right. Yeah, no, this is cool.
All right, here's my non-biased take on the matter. If someone sent me a card and said send it to these two people, I would send it to those two people only, and then I wouldn't send it to everyone else because I would assume that they took the responsibility of sending it to everyone else, and I wouldn't want to spam everyone. That would be my take on the matter.
Do you mind, so?
That's non-biased.
Could you show the DM to the lot or on your stream if you haven't, Rob? Because like this is kind of fucked up, but it's okay. Like I don't mind. But wish you would have told me or talked to me or.